Imagining creates reality. I say this because I identify imagining with God in action. To me, man is all imagination, and God is man, and exists in us and we in him. The eternal body of man is the imagination, and that is God himself. If by God I mean the creator of the universe, the maker and the master of the whole vast universe, and I identify that creator with the human imagination, then man should be more careful as to what he is imagining. So I can give lip service to the statement, imagining creates reality. And yet if I'm observant in the course of a day, if I observe what I'm imagining, I would find unnumbered moments in my life, in one 24 hours or other, the waking 18, where I am imagining things I do not wish to experience. If I really believed that imagining creates reality, I would be more careful, more concerned about what I am imagining. So I will give it lip service and say imagining creates reality and go blindly on imagining anything other than what I want to create. Imagination is spiritual sensation. Spiritual sensation. But how would I feel after him and fight him? Well, first of all, he does all things, good, bad, or indifferent. And he waits on me just as indifferently and as swiftly when the will in me is evil as when it is good. Because he is a creative power. He kills, he makes alive. He wounds, he heals. All things are done by the one creative power. There isn't another God who is evil and one that is good, one that is altogether loving and one that is altogether hating. No, only one power. And that power is the human imagination. So, how will I then feel after him? What would the feeling be like if it were true? What true? That I am the man that I would like to be. What would the feeling be like? Test it. For all things are made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. Well, now, if I dare to assume that I am now the man that I want to be, and I persist in that assumption, watching my mind morning, noon, and night, that anything that I find myself dwelling upon that is in conflict with that assumption, I ignore it, I put it aside. I will be faithful to this divine vision, the vision of myself. So anytime I catch myself daring to feel less than the thing that I'm feeling or trying to externalize in my world, I simply stop it and go back to that assumption that I am the man that I want to be. If I persist in it and it becomes a fact, then I have found him. I don't observe imagining as I do objects in space. I am the reality that is called imagining. So you don't see God because God is spirit, but you see the results of his activity in you. He is active in you as you imagine. You're completely free to imagine good, bad, or indifferent. So you simply select what you want to imagine. Would you like to be, and you name it. Well, you say, but I don't have the background for it. I do not have any of the qualifications for it. It doesn't really matter. If imagining creates reality, you do not need the qualifications that the world thinks you need. All you need to do is simply to boldly assume that you are the man, the woman that you would like to be. And if it proves itself in performance, then you have found it.